Hi friends, last class we have discussed what is meant by grid connected PV systems. Now let us see what are the different issues of grid connected PV systems. So what are the different problems we may face while connecting our PV system to the electric grid. Let us discuss all these points. The first point is problems connecting with power quality, storage, protection issues, short circuit level change, reverse power flow, lack of sustained fault current, islanding. So I think under protection issues itself, there are three types. One is short circuit level change, reverse power flow, and lack of sustained fault current. Let us discuss all these things one by one. First, problems concerning with power quality. As the renewable distributed generations are integrated through a power electronic converter to the grid, they may usually inject harmonics. So this is the common property of every power electronic converter, to inject harmonics into the system, as the power electronic converters comprises of semiconductor devices which have non-linear characteristics. So definitely they will produce some non-linear items. Those items are called harmonics, where it has multiple of fundamental frequency. So they have so many harmonics, maybe third harmonic, fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic. In that way the harmonics are defined, and those will be discussed in the power quality course, and those harmonics will be generally injected by the power electronic converters because of their switching devices. So these harmonics are caused by switching action of power electronic switches in the inverter, which produce poor quality of power supplied to the customers. So what we have just now discussed, so the main reason of these things are switching action of power electronic switches. So because of that, definitely there are some harmonics injected into the system. So this is the one of the problems when we connect the PV system to the grid. So what is the solution? The solution is shown in the green color. Soft switching control of inverters, active or passive filters are used to eradicate the harmonics. So these are the very simple solution, and so many methods are there in the each and every topic. Soft switching control of inverters, that means we will use some soft switch while controlling the inverters. Or active filters are there, so they actively take these so many inputs, maybe from input voltage, input current, or output voltage, output current, sometimes both of them, and they will change, they will see that the power factor is unity. And sometimes we can use passive filters also. They definitely reduce the cost compared to active filters. If the system is not that much problematic, you can use passive filters also. Sometimes we can use both of them to get the very good power quality. So these are the different aspects, and those will be definitely discussed in the power quality course. So these are the some types to eradicate the harmonics. Let us move on further. And there is one more problem: when the disconnection or connection of renewable energy source to the grid, depending on the load demand, causes voltage flickers. That means if the depending on the load demand, we need to connect or we need to disconnect our distributed generation to grid. In this aspect, while connecting and disconnecting our distributed generation from and to the power grid, there is some voltage flickers. So those are unwanted voltage flickers, and sometimes they may be very huge and they may damage the distributed generation or the power grid also. So without doing these hazardous things, we need to do, the solution is appropriate tap setting of the transformer connecting the feeder should be made. Actually, we need to use a transformer over there, and the transformer should have the tap setting. The tap setting should be proper. That means we need to provide proper tap fitting so that we can reduce the voltage flicker. So as the voltage flicker is the matter of magnitude, so we can very simply do it. We can reduce it or we can increase it by using transformers. Okay, this is the solution for it. So these are the power quality concerning problems where harmonics are there and voltage flickers are there. Let's move on to the storage. How the storage is very important case in terms of our distributed generation. So let us see what exactly the storage means and what are the issues we need to face. The incorporation of PV source in the grid, the standard of the grid comes down. So obviously standard of grid comes down because it's a DC. The output of PV is DC and we need to convert into AC. So definitely there is some disturbance in the grid. We need to create that disturbance. So the grid acts as a source or sink of power in accordance to the power generated from the PV system. So definitely sometimes it will act as the source and sometimes it will act as the sink depending upon the PV system. That means if the sun is there, we can generate the supply to the grid after utilizing by ourselves, and if sun is not there, we need to get the power from the grid. So definitely in that case the grid will act as the source. If we don't have the sun, if we have the sun and if we have surplus power, the grid will act as the sink. So definitely there is a bidirectional power flow in that aspect. So if the PV power generation is surplus, battery can be made as a choice of storing the excess power. So we can use battery also to avoid this power flow from DC to power grid. But introducing a battery to the grid connected PV system invites battery current and voltage control. If you introduce the battery to make the power grid as the sink, that means if you don't like to send the power to power grid from the distributed power generation, you can use a battery. If any surplus power is there, the power goes to the battery and it will store there. But if you use a battery, definitely there is some controlling technique you need to use to make the battery current and battery voltage proper. Coming to protection issues. So what are the protection issues? Traditional power systems are also having protection issues. Let us discuss them. Traditional power system. Coming to protection issues. So protection is always required for any power system. So in traditional power systems also, we have protection by using overcurrent protection, over voltage relays. So for protecting over currents and over voltage, we use relays and circuit breakers. As the energy conversion system is introduced, the protection becomes complex. So obviously, if there is no energy conversion, so definitely we have limited number of protection devices only, maybe relays and circuit breakers for voltage, over voltage and over current only. But if energy conversion system is introduced, the protection becomes definitely complex, because we need to see the frequency also in these aspects. So the next problem is the issue of alteration in short circuit level, lack of sustained fault current and reverse power flow persists. So these three issues were prominently introduced if the energy conversion system is introduced. So let us see if these three things can be discussed in a broader manner in the coming things. One is short circuit level, lack of sustained fault current and reverse power flow thing. Let us see. Short circuit level change. So what does it mean? Short circuit level change. Actually, one level is there, that is short circuit level. If it crosses that level, definitely the device has to be shut down. Okay, that is the thing we are giving to the relays or circuit breakers. Okay, that is some benchmark. Okay, that is the level. So let us see what he has introduced. The short circuit level is an important design parameter in the design of protective devices such as circuit breakers and relays, obviously. So this is usually characterized by the equivalent system impedance, at the fault point and indicates the amount of fault current for the relay to act upon the fault. It depends upon the impedance at the fault point and it gives the fault current where the device has to be operated. And this is very important point. So the equivalent impedance doesn't vary with the grid powered network systems. It doesn't vary with that. It only varies with the fault. Whenever the fault occurs, it definitely the impedance will vary. But it varies with the DG network. Whenever fault occurs, definitely as the DG is always a variable thing. So definitely it changes. So changes instantly also. So that's the problem with DG connected grid connected DG systems. Since the short circuit current varies, the forecast of the fault current magnitude changes, which cannot be withstood by the design circuit breaker rating right through the operation. The problem is, for the circuit breaker we will put one short circuit current, but because of this DG, even the fault occurs or when the short circuit happens, yes, the DG is also variable and it won't show the proper short circuit current. If that proper short circuit level, it is not showing proper short circuit level, but the short circuit level is as it is. So what happened? Definitely there is a problem and the circuit breaker won't operate at the level where it has to be operated. So that's the problem. So the circuit breaker can't see the proper short circuit level what it was designed for it. Okay, that's the problem. And reverse power flow, as we know, conventional power system possesses unidirectional power flow. So no customer will give us the power to the grid if it is a conventional power system. But coming to renewable energy power system, consumer may give the power, consumer may take the power. So it's a bi-directional thing. Definitely it alters the operation of the protective circuits. For example, if we put a relay or circuit breaker just to whenever the current passes from one point to other point. But now we need to provide the protection device such that whenever the current passes from one point to other point or other point to one point, also, that means A to B or B to A, we need to make them as bidirectional. Next, lack of sustained fault current. So I'm extremely sorry, whenever we discuss the short circuit level, that's different and fault current is different. Short circuit level means whenever short circuit occurs, the device has to be operated. Fault current means whenever fault occurs, fault is different, short circuit is different. Okay, please keep that in mind. Now, lack of sustained fault current. Actually, when fault occurs, the current has to be changed, and once the current changed, based on that, the relays or circuit breakers will operate. But here, we are unable to get the sustained, the proper fault current whenever fault occurs because of these DGs. So definitely the protecting device never operates. So the damage, whatever it has to be, that will be done. That's the problem. So for the protection of the system from the fault current, switch gear and circuit breakers are installed. So which differentiates the fault current from the normal current. That's what their job is. But this differentiation is made with the significant increase in the fault current than the normal current. Obviously, if the current is 2 ampere, nothing may happen. If the circuit breaker is designed for 5 ampere, if the current is 2 ampere, the system is okay and system is healthy. If the current is 6 ampere, definitely the circuit breaker has to see the 6 ampere, and as its limit is 5 ampere, so it won't allow the current. That's what happened normally. But if the magnitude of the fault current varies from the distributed generation, then there is a tough task for the circuit breaker to identify the fault current amidst the normal current. So it was unable to identify the 6 ampere current. As the 6 ampere current is there, but still because of DG, it may show as 4 ampere. And as it is 4 ampere, it feels that the system is healthy and it allows the current. But after it becomes 6 ampere, it will be damage. That's the problem. So solar systems mainly employ power electronic switches which don't supply sustained fault current. So this is the problem. Actually, power electronic switches won't give you proper current, so it will give you some harmonic current or some reduced current. Definitely how when harmonics entered means the current will be reduced a bit. I mean the active, the proper current will be reduced. So that's the problem with these systems, okay, PV systems. Next, islanding. What is meant by islanding? Islanding is a unique problem of grid connected PV system. Islanding occurs on grid failure. If grid is failed, our system will be islanded. That means the system will be thrown, disconnected from the grid. So auto reclosure valve at the point of common coupling of renewable generator to the grid is kept open, offering the separation of the utility network with the grid. So this is the what we need to do, auto reclosure valve. So it has to be reclosed automatically, and those valves should be placed at the point of common coupling where the DC is connected to the grid. Else the voltage builds up on the power generation without the energy absorption by the grid, causing huge voltage unbalance, resulting in the system deterioration. Yeah, otherwise what happened if it is not automatically reclosed, we need to close separately, and in that time what happened, the huge current will, huge voltage unbalance will occur. That results in system deterioration. The system will, the quality of the system will be reduced. Thus, the anti-islanding control technique came into picture for addressing the above problem. So, without having these problems, we need to use anti-islanding control. So, what are those? The standard anti-islanding control techniques include over voltage relay, over under voltage relay, over voltage relay, over frequency relay, and under frequency relays. So relays are used for anti-islanding purpose. So these are the main issues, grid issues, when we connect our distributed generation, especially PV system, to electric power grid. So thank you so much for listening to my lecture, and please like if you like this video, and if you share this video, kindly share it. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please be subscribed and kindly press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. Thank you. Thank you so much.